大家好，我是 Sarah。 上一次我们介绍了如何戴非常有设计感的帽子，也了解了羽毛帽和头饰的佩戴礼仪。接下来我们就会分享一下如何根据不同的季节选用不同材质的帽子。不同的场合应该戴不同的帽子，不同的季节也应该选用不同材质来制作礼帽。下面我请我的好朋友 Elizabeth 来和大家介绍一下不同的季节应该选用什么材质的帽子才好。 Elizabeth, do you mind explaining to us different materials for different seasons?
Sure, absolutely. This is probably the most popular material used in hat making. It's called cinnamay, and it's made of a natural fiber, so it's easy to mold over the shape that we want to make. It's used a lot in the royals' hats. It's a really light hat to wear in the summer or spring. And this is great. It's light on the head. It feels great. You hardly can feel that you're wearing a hat. In the winter, of course, we have wool. This is fur felt. You can feel that it's kind of soft and furry, velour fur felt. This is made of wool felt, so it's 100% wool, and it's felted together. And of course, you can use a lot of other materials. In the case of these two, I've used crin. This is from Switzerland. Mm-hmm. I work a lot with Swarovski crystals, so that makes it nice and sparkly. And for example, this one's only made of feathers, and that gives a really nice shape. There's a lot of things you can do. The possibilities are endless.
原来是这样。那么现在是夏天，所以我可以选择一个这样的帽子吧。这个宽边的，我戴一下。Summer wide brim hat.
Beautiful, yes. This one was en vogue.
Oh, 不过戴这样的帽子，在太阳落山的时候，记得要把它摘下，因为晚上是不能戴宽边的帽子的哟。另外呢，我发现在中国没什么店会卖绿色的帽子。
绿帽子不可以。No, green hats in China are not really the way to go because apparently there's a saying that if a man wears a green hat, that his wife is cheating on him.
Oh, 原来是这样。所以记得别让你的男友或者你的老公戴一个绿色的帽子哟。好了，现在你们知道如何根据不同的季节选用不同材质的帽子啦。瑞雅礼仪只为更完美的你。